Oh no, I haven't been out enough yet. Anyways, first point went to Canada by about 1 million points. Worthless, which is nobody won. Just waiting a moment. Here's what we've got our next pick. It's going to be Hidden One. Astro Girl. We'll get chat after this map. Not sure who and what picked what. First point was won by Canada. They played Nomad 1. FCs from Iba, Ninja Juju, and Flip YT. On the other side, we had an FC from Riffletoppy. So we'll wait. Here are the rosters. It's been a week since we've seen them. Japan is Kuki Loa with the US flag, but he's on the Japan team, along with Rufutaku, Sino, Sunakaze, Rosina, Lighthana, Wawakana, and Naraka. And he's got Gordon, Iba, Non Nevermind, Flick, Sinker, Ninja Juju, Zephyr, and Shinobu. And he's the top seed of the group, and is the high seed. Like we have on seeding screen, which actually works. 10, 11 calls. Canada number 3. Very good hidden team. Whereas Japan did fairly well on the mods. Which makes me think that this hidden one pick was probably by Japan. So we're gonna have Flick, Shubu, Ninja Juju, and Iba. Those are definitely not players in the right slot, so they're gonna have to get moved around. I guess I should go ping the referee. Alright, so the teams are actually flipped on screen. Canada is on the left, Japan is on the right. And we also lost Cookie Roll, apparently. Not sure exactly what is going on, as we don't have chat yet. I'll do a quick client restart. They might have done an abort, but I'm not sure. Sorry for the scuff. Surprise stream. Wasn't expecting to stream this one, to be honest. We'll be right back. Okay, so it just looks like they did have an abort. And after reaching a client, you aren't able to get as many clients, so we're actually not going to see most of Japan for about a minute. So, sorry about that. We will continue to try restarting clients until they load. It's just the limitation of the German client. Generally only notice after a crash on the 4v4. Japan is here. Just the client is limited on connections. But for now, we can see that Canada does have a 4-way FC. And Kukuloa is holding on for Japan. On the plus side, we didn't have to actually download any maps this week since group stage is 2 weeks long. Same map pool. According to the internet, still got a 99.3 from both Shinobu and Ninja Juju. Probably gonna have to wait a couple of minutes, like I said, to get the extra clients. Fortunately, it is a 3-minute long song, so we may actually catch the end of Japan's Blizz. Oh, there was a break from Kukuloa at some point about halfway into the map. So that will need to be countered by a couple of breaks in Japan, Canada now, to allow Japan to get back into it. Happy, please let me connect more. Hey, there we go. Let's see how we're doing for Japan. You get a break from Flick, about 400 comboing. Ball client is broken recently, seems to be a bit behind, so it must have broken a few times earlier as well. And seems because they also had broken. So this is going to be a fairly big win for Canada here on the second point, and they will be ahead 2-0. FCs from Shinobu, Ninja Juju for Canada, Rifotaku for Japan. And it is 2-0 in favor of Canada. Yeah, so somebody suggested just flipping the teams. Let me do that. In a minute. Of course, as soon as I restart the client, we're going to lose all of the slots again. But hey, we're in between maps, so I think we'll have to chat by now. So, worst case, we at least get the gameplay from most of the players. That's kind of all we're here for, right? Next pick is going to be True My Heart, Hard Rock 2. Alright, so we don't have Shay yet. Looks like the teams are swapping sides to have the team names match up. Alright, so after the last two maps, I have no idea who's actually winning. I mean, who picked what? I'd imagine maybe Japan picked about two, but they only picked them on one, so I don't know. They were quicker than hidden though, so I'm willing to imagine that this is a canon figure. And if I'm wrong, I'm wrong. Looks like we'll be seeing Light Hana joining for the first time today for Japan. Tsunekaze returning. Did play on Nomad 1. Oh wait, no, did join. Joining Mifotaku and Kukilo. Hana's got Zephyr so far. Not sure about the other slots. They may be filled. No, they're just not in lobby yet. I'll use for the, unprepared stream here today. Surprise stream. Apparently we're playing Hidden One again in slot 3. And this time we're not going to get Canada. There we go. We've got Flick, Gordon, in for the first time, I believe. As well as Iba joining. This is the Hardock 2 pick, small circle size. No breaks off of getting Canada with a slight lead behind a pair of double S's so far, one for Japan. Kukilo will be the first to break for Japan. Lahana breaking as well, so early advantage to Canada. This might have been Canada's pick. Look at those hit point buffers drain, even though they're FCing. It's because it's hard rock with high hit points. Flick breaking for Canada, that's going to make the combo somewhat closer. So slightly favoring Canada. But that will stabilize the... Oh, everybody got breaking except for Rifotaku for Japan. Canada losing all the combo except for Zephyr. So it's Rifotaku and Zephyr with the FCs remaining. Similar accuracies. And with the 200k lead, a couple of breaks from Japan. So combo advantage to Canada once again as we cross into I guess about a third of the map remaining. Still come back to both for Japan, but they're gonna have to hold and need some breaks from Canada, especially the larger combos. And the FC is gone for Japan, except they're still holding. Canada's going to be running away with this one now. No FC though. Zephyr breaking. But we are in the last like 15% of the map. That should be more than enough to take this point. At that early break, actually, Kukulo's managed to recover pretty well. But top scorer in the lobby this time is going to be Zephyr. Lasted the longest with the FC. Broke late. 783k. Pretty good. About not too far behind. And actually, Mifotaku had the second top score at 709k, also with the one miss, about a two-thirds way into the map. And that'll be a third point to Canada. I think that was their pick, but nobody's telling me anything, and I don't have access to the ref sheet. So, don't look at me. So usually, once you get chat, you're able to determine the bands because it's in chat, and we just don't have chat yet. Anyways, assuming that was Canada's pick, we're going to be waiting on a pick from Japan here. And it's going to be Takedoni Nomad 3. Maybe this is Canada's pick. I have no idea. Once Japan takes a point, I think we'll know whose pick it is. Or somebody in chat could tell us, because I think half the players are in chat. Well, if it's alternating picks, we're going to call this Japan's pick, but I have no idea. There's Nomad 3. It's going to be Naraka, Kukuloa, Tsunakaze, and Rufotaki for Japan. Canada's going with Zephyr, Flick, Emma, and Nah, Nevermind. That's where DT2 for Canada and Harbor for Japan. Thank you, Gordon. Whose pick was this, by the way? This was Canada's pick. Okay. Definitely got all the picks backwards. So that means that first pick was Japan with Nomad 1, then we saw a hidden one for Canada, Hardback 2, Japan, and now Nomad 3 for Canada. And we saw were DT2 and Hardback 1. Thank you, Gordon, for that. So 3-0 in paper of Canada. Looking to get to match point here on their second pick. They are the top seed of this group, and I believe they're already 2-0, so if they win this, they pretty much clinch moving on to the round of 16 next week. Both of these teams have won 2 matches so far. So Japan still has a very good chance of advancing. If they were to win their last match, I believe they definitely advanced to 3-1. Assuming they lose this, they could still come back though. I guess my point is both of these teams will probably get to the round of 16 unless there is a big upset. So early on, AK advanced to Canada. Most players, around 96-98%, Naraka will be the first player to break. Oh, I guess Lenha actually broke early. I missed that as well. Hit the combo in. Practically FC though. Far away for Canada. it was their pick. We would expect them to be fairly solid on this one. And we've already seen two matches from them anyway. Zephyr breaking. So, not 3v2 in terms of FCs. Practically 3v3. As we go into the second half of the map, Canada with the 200k lead. And, you know, continuing to break. Not having the best time on this map. Looking at a 98.5, a 98.0, and 97% accuracy FC from Canada. Meanwhile, for Japan, could be lower than matching the 98 actually. We could talk about the 97. But Canada just has one extra FC and a bit higher supporting act. And we're gonna go ahead by about 500k. Not much map left to go. Question is, will the five remaining FCs hold? And it looks like they will. Two FCs for Japan, three for Canada. Canada taking their fourth point here. And they are on match point. $17,100 from Nod, never mind. A lot more slider ends dropped from I-Bomb, but still practically an FC. And Cookie Loa, I guess, would be the next top score, 930k. It's just 2100s for Japan. And we're on 4-0. It's Canada. It is Japan's pick, however. So maybe they can find a good one to counteract Canada's roster. It's going to be a rough ride, though. It's just a really solid all-around team. Especially as now we're in week 2 group stage, I think these players have seen the map a little bit more. You're not catching anybody by surprise this weekend. And we're going to be seeing Bunny Bunny Karakart. Which was just ranked recently, actually. This is Fremont number 1. So, I believe the Fremont rules are you have to have at least one player with Hard Rock, at least one player with Hidden without Hard Rock, and the rest is free. Something like a 1.75, 1.8x multiply for easy is 1.8. Yeah, we will have matches all throughout the day, Saturday, and hopefully a good amount Sunday, although we might be down a few streamers. Currently the next planned stream is at 11:30. United Kingdom against Australia. In Group F. And then also streaming at 13, I think. Not sure which match, but there are several matches happening at 13 and 14 UTC. I'm trying to get as many as I can, but once again, I think we have like maybe 2 streamers available. We'll see. Stay tuned. Check the Discord. We'll post stream announcements when there are matches to stream. The goal is to get at least one stream match on the main one of the main channels for each team. Beyond that, as many as we can. There had been 7 teams, I believe, that had not been on stream yet as of yesterday, although I think it's 6 because Australia did get streamed. They didn't play any of their matches last week, so of course they didn't get streamed yet. The other team that had played 0 matches through last week was Singapore. We'll be seeing one of their matches tomorrow. Well, by tomorrow I mean today. It's already Saturday. Anyways, we're underway. Looking at Sunokaze, Ukilo, Rukotaku, and Naraka in Port Japan. Naraka breaking their Honda with Zephyr, Ninja Juju, Aiba, and Now Never Mind. Two of them broke. Another play from Japan break. So, combo wise, we are approximately even. Two FCs versus two. Looking at the mods, we got a hidden Hard Rock from Tsunekaze and Zephyr on opposite sides. Hidden from Rufotaku and Aiba, and then no mods in the remaining four plays. So they'll be looking to get solid plays from the no mod players. It is AR 8.5, which is maybe not the most comfortable for some players if they're used to playing AR 9 or higher all the time. But not too bad. The remaining FCs are Rufotaku on Hidden, Aiba also on Hidden, and then Ninja Juju for Canada on Nomad. Hard players slightly favoring Canada. Zephyr's got a higher combo built up. And then the Nomads are, well, all of them broke really except for Ninja Juju. Running out of time here. Canada's going up by 500k, Zephyr breaking again, but that's really not going to matter. Almost everybody from Canada breaks right now. And that'll be it. A 5-0 sweep for Canada. Finishing off this match here over Japan. They will go to 3-0. Canada definitely making it out of groups. I think they have one more match remaining this weekend. I'll be moving on to the round 16. Japan now moves to 2-1. They should make it out of groups, but they do have one more match that they will likely need to win. And the match is against Thailand at 13 UTC Sunday. Thailand, of course, is the bottom seed of the group, so you would expect Japan to win, but there have been quite a few upsets in group stage, so you never know what's going to happen. Anyways, that's going to be it for